Can you see in there if you're going live?
Let's see. Not yet. Yes, now I'm live. Hello, everybody. We are testing the sound. We have had a little hiatus with the sound, so if you can tell me if you are here as well and if you can see us well, so then we can start with our crochet along part two today. So please write in the comments if you can hear us well, and then we can start. Okay? And if the light is good and everything, and where are you coming from and everything? I guess the sound is fine. Wow, thank you, Sharon, for the shout out. I hope that many Hook Ninjas can join us. We are just starting, so you can jump, go grab your hook, grab your yarn, and then we can start. You will be needing a 3.5 millimeter hook. You will need a tapestry needle, and then for today, you will be needing this yarn that is green yarn and a little bit of
red
stuffing. Oh, yes. Red yarn, yeah, sorry. So that's what we are gonna do today, and today we are gonna be crocheting only the body. So this is gonna be a fast live stream, and I hope that you could join us, and I hope that you can hear us well. So if you are ready, we are ready. So let me know if you are ready, guys.
Can you get a confirmation from someone if they can hear us?
I guess that they can hear us well, because here someone like, thank you, Terry, for the thumbs up. Oh, the light went down. So I think we are gonna start. En español. Hola amigos, bienvenidos al Crochet Along. Today, hoy vamos a estar haciendo la parte del cuerpo de nuestra brujita. El Crochet Along, la parte de hoy es muy corta. No se va a demorar mucho porque hoy solamente vamos a estar haciendo el cuerpo. Los materiales que vamos a necesitar hoy para el cuerpo es simplemente lana roja, la aguja de crochet que utilizamos la semana pasada, que fue una de 3.5 o 4 dependiendo del grosor de su lana, una aguja capotera, un marcador de puntadas, si no tienen un marcador de puntadas, un pedacito de lana también funciona, y su relleno. En esta ocasión estoy reciclando una almohada, entonces voy sacando aquí de mi almohadita. Hay que ser ecológicos, no hay necesidad de estar comprando todo nuevo. Y ahora voy a hablar en inglés para los que nos están viendo en inglés. So now I'm switching to English again. And yes, welcome to our crochet along. I'm very happy that you are joining us. This is our second part of the crochet along. Last week we did the head of our witch, and you can find the tutorial. Our live stream is down in our Facebook page, and also you can find the pattern in the Facebook page as well. We have an album for the head. The pattern for what we are gonna do today, I'm gonna be posting it after our live stream. So the materials that we are gonna need for today are a 3.5 millimeter hook, or 4 depending on the weight of your yarn, and then red yarn. This is a little bit dark red. Then you will be needing a tapestry needle, and then you will be needing a stitch marker. Okay, so I think we are gonna start. So let me move these things to here. Let me move my notes where I have the pattern written, and then we are gonna start. The question for today, for all the hook ninjas that are tuning in with us, is the first question is, what is your favorite costume? It doesn't matter if you are not dressing up, but what would you like to dress like? For example, for me, I would like to have a sumo costume. And I think it's awesome that you could pump it with air and then you could just go in the street like this. So please let me know what is your ideal costume. And then now we are going to start crocheting. La pregunta para hoy es, ¿cuál sería su disfraz ideal? Para mí, el disfraz ideal sería un disfraz de luchador de sumo, que se le puede echar aire por dentro y salir uno así todo gordito pues a la calle con su colita de sumo y poder rodar y todo. Bueno, ahora sí, díganme que, cuál es su disfraz ideal en los comentarios y ahora sí empecemos. Ok, so I'm gonna move towards this other camera and then I will need to watch a little bit here from the screen. My hands, could you tilt it a little bit more, please? Thank you. Okay, so here I am. I hope that you can see my hands well. I'm gonna move the camera a little bit towards here. Yeah. Okay, so we are starting by creating, I'm gonna show you here. We have two pieces that then we have attached together. And then we started crocheting in circles until we reach the top of our amigurumi. Lo que hicimos con este cuerpo fue que hicimos dos piezas y después de ahí las tejimos juntas hasta la parte de arriba de nuestro proyecto. ¿Ok? Vamos a empezar. All right. We are gonna start. I'm gonna put our witch here in this side so she can be supervising us. And then, maybe I put it this side. There we go. Okay, whatever. So, the first round, la ronda número uno, is.
Are we sharp?
Hello.
Hi guys.
Hello, John. John is also helping here, so. Okay, so round number one. For round number one, we will stitch 6 into a magic ring. Para la ronda número uno, vamos a hacer un anillo mágico de 6 puntos bajos. Okay, let's start. 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So now that we have our stitches in there, we are gonna tie them up. And now we have round number one. Después de que tenemos el anillo mágico de 6 puntos bajos, apretamos bien. Y vamos a movernos a la ronda número 2. And then we are gonna move ourselves to round number 2. Okay, for round number 2, we have double single crochet in next stitch around. Double single crochet in each stitch around. En español, la segunda vuelta es un punto bajo en cada uno de los 6 puntos bajos que ya teníamos, o sea, en cada uno de los que tenemos aquí. Alright, are you ready? Let's go. ¿Listos? Vamos. Mm. dos, tres, cuatro, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and then last one, 11 and 12. We should have now a total of 12 stitches, and this is how it looks so far.
Can people see, or should we zoom in more?
Are you guys being able to watch well, or should we zoom in a little bit more? Please let us know in the comments. ¿Qué tal lo ven en este ángulo, chicos o chicas? ¿Debemos hacer un aumento aquí en la cámara o se ve bien? I think you could zoom in a little bit more.
It's light enough?
Yeah, I think it's light enough. Okay, we are in round number 2. You should have a total of 12 stitches. Estamos en la vuelta número 2. Tienen que tener un total de 12 puntadas alrededor. I'm gonna cut this little tail. Voy a cortar esta colita. Because it can get in the way. And now, we are gonna move to round number 3. But before, we have to put our stitch marker. Nos vamos a mover hacia la vuelta número 3. Pero primero voy a poner el marcador. Y acuérdense de contarme cuál sería su disfraz ideal. And remember to tell me what will be your favorite costume, your ideal costume. All right, so we are moving to round number 3. For round number 3, we have double single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next stitch. And that will be a total of 18 stitches. Double single crochet in next stitch, single crochet in next stitch. That will be a total of 18 stitches. En español, sería la vuelta número 3, dos puntos bajos y un aumento para un total de 18 puntadas. Repito, vuelta número 3. Dos puntos bajos y un aumento para un total de 18 puntadas. Alright, so are you ready? ¿Están listos? Ok, let's go. Four, five, and six. Seven, eight, and nine. Ten, 11, and 12. 13, 14. 15, 16, 17, 18. All right, so now we finish round number 3. Ya terminamos la ronda número 3, tenemos que tener 18 puntadas. We should have 18 stitches all around. Let's see, let's make a round of comments. Hi there from Marlborough, UK. Hello, Sue. Nice to meet you and thanks for tuning in with us today. It looks good, great, thank you, Susana. Leonor, un aumento de cámara, por favor. Listo, ya aumentamos la cámara. El estambre es más delgado que el de la cabeza. Es un poquitico más delgado. Eso es verdad, pero estoy usando la misma aguja. La verdad, la diferencia es casi mínima, pero es cuestión de gusto. Si ustedes quieren utilizar uno un poquito más grueso, lo pueden hacer. La verdad, cuando les muestro aquí en la cámara, no se puede notar la diferencia tanto. Entonces, yo lo que hice fue utilizar lana que tenía en mi casa. Y la verdad, no noto la diferencia, así estoy usando la misma aguja. Así que es cuestión de gustos.
In English?
In English, she was asking me, Leonor was asking me if I'm using a little bit thinner yarn. I told her that yes, that in this project I'm trying to reuse yarn that I have in my house, and that this one is slightly thinner. The difference I can't really notice it that much in the body, as you can see here. The tightness of the stitches is pretty much the same, and I'm using the same hook. So it's up to you if you want to use the same weight of the yarn. I am just using yarns that I don't use that often, and I thought that this was a good project to use them for not leaving them there somewhere for many years. Okay, so now we need to check here. What do we need to do now? So we are gonna move to round number 3. Vamos a movernos, perdón, a la vuelta número 4. Sorry, we are gonna move to round number 4. In round number 4, we are gonna just stitch around, and the total of stitches is 18. En la vuelta número 4 solamente vamos a hacer una pasada normal y el total es de 18 puntadas. Okay, so now we are gonna start round number 4. Let's see if my hands are in the right place and let's go.
What are you doing in round 4?
I just explained.
In Spanish you explained.
Yeah, I explained too.
In English.
In English and in Spanish. Okay. So let's go. Vamos. Una. Two. Three. Four. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10, 11, 12, 13. So now we change our stitch marker, cambiamos el marcador de la puntada actual y vamos a mirar cómo va nuestra patita, and we will see how our leg is doing. Okay, so now we have that round ready. And let's check for the comments and see if you guys have commented more. Looking forward to making hair. I need to catch up and do the head. Yes, you can separate about 1.5 hours to make the head, and then maybe 1/2 hour to make the body, and then you are ready to catch up, and then we can make the details together. Buenas, hola Susi, bienvenida. Apenas estamos empezando, todavía tienes tiempo. Okay, so now we have finished round number 4. Acabamos de terminar la ronda número 4 y now we are gonna move to round number 5 to 6. Vamos ahora a pasar a la ronda número 5. de las 5 a las 6. And in that round, we are gonna do exactly the same. We are gonna just teach a round. And that will be for 2 rounds, 5 and 6. En estas dos rondas, las 5 y las 6, lo único que vamos a hacer es pasadas. Alright? No, sorry. Erase what I just said. Sorry, guys. I'm a little bit tired, so you have to be patient with me today. Finland is getting darker and darker, and no matter how much you drink coffee, sometimes it happens. The thing is, we are gonna cut this leg. Sorry about that. And we are just gonna leave it like this for a while. And we are gonna repeat exactly the same, so we can make this other leg. I'm really sorry about that confusion in there. Lo que vamos a hacer es, y me disculpan por ese error, en Finlandia se está volviendo más oscuro cada vez y ando cansadita, es que vamos a cortar esta parte de la lana y vamos a esperar para poder unir las dos patitas. Tenemos que hacer exactamente lo mismo. Alright. So now, let's start with the leg number 2. And we are gonna do exactly the same. So we start by stitching 6 into a magic ring. Para hacer la patita número 2, estamos en la ronda número 1 y vamos a hacer el anillo mágico de 6 puntos bajos otra vez. One, two, three, four, five, and six. And then we tied up our magic ring, apretamos nuestro anillo mágico, and then we are ready with round number 1. Of our second leg. Y estamos listos con la ronda número 1 de nuestra pata número 1. Pata número 2. Alright, so now we move to round number 2. For round number 2, we have double single crochet in each stitch around, and we have a total of 12 stitches. En la segunda vuelta, estamos haciendo un punto bajo en cada una de las vueltas que tenemos aquí, en cada una de las puntadas. Alright, are we ready? Let's go. Double single crochet around. Uno, two, three, and 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. All right. So now we have 12, ahora tenemos 12, and we are gonna install our stitch marker. Y podemos instalar nuestro marcador. I'm gonna take this one away and move it to the other leg, because this one we already finished. Voy a mover mi marcador hacia la otra partita, porque ya en el otro no la necesitamos. And we are gonna move to round number 3, where we are doing exactly the same than the other one. We are doing double single crochet in next stitch and single crochet in next stitch for a total of 18 stitches. En español, vamos para la vuelta número 3, donde vamos a hacer 2 puntos bajos y un aumento. Okay, so let's go. 1, 17 and 18. All right, and now this is how it looks our round number 3. Esto es como se ve la rumba número 3. And we are gonna move to round number 4. Y nos vamos a ir a la vuelta número 4. Vamos a ver qué dicen nuestras amigas Hook Ninjas. Let's see what the Hook Ninjas are saying here. I have a dude. Tengo una dudita, pero en la cabeza. Los ojos, ¿en qué hileras iban? Así ya lo relleno. Susi, los ojos los puedes poner donde tú quieras. La verdad, yo no cuento dónde pongo mis ojos. Lo dejo a la preferencia de la persona que esté haciendo el amigurumi. ¿Por qué? Porque en lo que yo he estudiado sobre amigurumi, me parece que las personas, así las personas estén siguiendo un patrón. Cada uno de nosotros tenemos una personalidad diferente y sería genial que así las personas estén siguiendo los patrones, están siguiendo, por ejemplo, un live stream como este, que le den su propio toque a sus amigurumis. Entonces yo solamente les sugiero que los ojos estén al frente de la cara. El resto ya es su propia preferencia. Yo los pongo en toda la mitad. Así que yo les aconsejo también que ustedes experimenten y miren a ver dónde les gusta a ustedes sus ojitos. ¿Ok? Espero que esa respuesta les guste. I was telling Susie that she was asking me where should I put the eyes, and I told her that during all these years that I have been researching about amigurumi, I have always encouraged you, Hook Ninjas, to put the eyes wherever you feel that is your own creation. Even though you are making a pattern from someone else, you could put your own soul and your own taste in your amigurumi, so you can put them wherever you feel that they resonate with you. So the only thing that I always suggest is that put the eyes in front of the face. That's the only thing, and then you can play with them. You can make them sad, you can make them happy, los pueden poner bravos, contentos, así que ustedes deciden. Do we have more questions? El de la cabeza ya está en la página. Hi again, Alejandra! Welcome! Nice that you are joining us. El de la cabeza ya está en la página, Susi. Está ahí en la parte de abajo. Si le das scroll hacia abajo, ahí está el de la cabeza. ¿Listo? Okay. So now we are moving to round number 4. In round number 4, en la ronda número 4, we are doing the stitch around. Estamos haciendo una pasada. And we should have a total of 18 stitches. Tenemos que tener un total de 18 puntadas. All right, let's go.
Can you read from
4,
there?
5? Yeah, I'm gonna read after. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oops. 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18, and we are moving our marker. 18, y movemos nuestro marcador, and then I'm gonna make another round for the comments that you have. Perdón, ¿cuántos puntos quedaron ahorita? Leonor, los puntos que quedaron ahorita, les voy a repetir todos. I'm gonna repeat the amount of stitches that you should have in each round so you have it very clear. In the round number one, you should have a total of 6 stitches. En la vuelta número uno, tienen que tener un total de 6 puntadas. In round number two, you should have a total of 12 stitches. En la vuelta número 2 tienen que tener un total de 12 puntadas. In the round number 3, you should have a total of 18 stitches. En la vuelta número 3 tienen que tener un total de 18 puntadas. Y en la ronda, and the round number 4, you should have a total of 18 stitches. En la vuelta número 4 tienen que tener un total de 18 puntadas. Y ahí es donde vamos. And there is where we are right now. Okay, hello, kisses from Portugal. Thank you, Orlando. Kisses back. And it's very nice that you are looking at the live stream. And I hope that you can join the amigurumi making also, if you are not doing it right now. Leonor, ¿vamos a tener el patrón apuntado? Sí, el patrón va a estar apuntado después de del live stream. Lo voy a poner en la. En, de la misma manera que lo puse la semana pasada. The pattern is gonna be written after the live stream is done. I'm gonna put the pictures in the Facebook page in the same way that I did it last week. Los ojos van a la mitad de las hileras, pero está el video anterior todavía. I don't understand really what you mean. No entiendo bien qué es lo que dice. Sí, los ojos están en la mitad de la cabeza. Eso es verdad. Hoy, linda, bellos. Thank you, Sonia Oliveira. Thank you, gracias. Obrigada. That's the only word I know in Portuguese. Okay, so now we have done row number 4, and now we are gonna join these two legs that we have already made. As you see, here we have these two. And before we join them together, please don't cut this second one that we did. Por favor, no vayan a cortar la colita que tienen aquí con la lana. Porque la necesitamos para continuar. Because we need it to continue. Alright, so I pulled my tail in the first leg that we did, and I'm just gonna bind off here so this doesn't bother me. Few times, like this. Like that, and then I'm gonna cut so it doesn't bother me. If these tails don't bother you, estoy cortando las colitas porque a mí la verdad me desconcentran las colitas. Si a ustedes no las desconcentran las colitas, las pueden dejar ahí. I get this concentration issues if I have many tails hanging around. So now we have this little piece in here. That is leg number one that will correspond to this leg number one. And now we have leg number two that is still attached to the yarn. And that will be leg number two. Tenemos ya hechas la patita número uno, la pierna número uno, que sería la de la izquierda. Y la pierna número 2, que sería la de la derecha, y todavía está agarrada a la lana. No la vayan a cortar. ¿Ok? Alright, so now we are gonna go to the a little bit more challenging part. Please let me know if you have any questions. Ahora vamos a pasar a una parte que es un poquitito más difícil, pero no es imposible, que es juntar estas dos patas para continuar con el cuerpo. Okay, so I'm gonna explain first in English. Voy a explicar primero en inglés. You take both of your legs, you hold them together like so, This is my way of doing it, but there's many different ways.
Should we zoom in a little?
Okay, John is gonna try to zoom in a little bit here, so it's a lot easier for you to see. La explicación en español ya viene tantico. Espérenme un segundito. And remember to tell me what would be your ideal costume. Recuerden de contarme cuál sería su disfraz ideal para Halloween. Okay, we are zooming in so you can see better. Here already is quite good. And now we are sharp. There we go. All right, so the way I do it is that I take both legs. This one, I have it attached to the leg number 2, still to the yarn. And then I pass my hook through leg number 2 like this. And then I make a yarn over, then I have 2 loops, and then I yarn over again, and then I have it attached. Okay, I'm gonna...
Maybe you can take it off and do the same thing,
yeah.
Repeat the same thing, but in Spanish.
Now I'm gonna take it away, and I'm gonna do it in Spanish. Ahora sí, en español, castellano. Para castellano, español es. Todavía tengo mi aguja de crochet puesta en este orificio de acá que no sé cómo se llama en español, pero ustedes saben a qué me refiero. Y de ahí cojo la patita número 1, pongo la aguja por dentro de uno de los orificios del proyecto, así, y de ahí paso mi lana para hacer algo así como un punto bajo, se ve así, y de ahí hago otro punto bajo. O no sé si, cuénteme cómo se llama esto en español, apenas estoy aprendiendo a hacer crochet en español. Pero paso mi lana a través de los 2 que teníamos y se ve así. Vamos a ver si soy capaz de ponerlo aquí. Así se ve. ¿Ok? Alright, do you have any question so far? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta hasta aquí? Cuéntenme a ver si me entendieron bien. Punto enano o corrido. Muchas gracias. Lo voy a anotar aquí de una vez para yo poder aprender a punto enano. All right. Thank you very much to the Spanish speaking Hook Ninjas. They are teaching me the terms that I still don't know. I am practicing a lot to learn how to crochet in Spanish, but I still don't know some terms. So that's really great. Appreciate it. Seems clear. Great. Thank you very much, Sue. De las 10 explicaciones, de 10 las explicaciones. Gracias, 10 puntos. Qué bien. Las piernas parecen pequeñitas, sí, parecen pequeñitas porque los amigurumis que yo hago, casi todos tienen un cuerpo muy chiquito y una cabeza muy grandotota. Someone is asking me that the legs look very small, and that's true because the style of my amigurumis are that they have very small body and then they have a humongous head. But that's just my style. If you like it to do it a little bit bigger, you can just increase the number of stitches. Ese es solamente mi estilo, no es que tiene que ser así. Si ustedes quieren hacerlo un poquito más grande, Lo único que tienen que hacer es aumentar más vueltas con punto bajo. Ok, so now we continue. We are here in the part that we just finish joining both legs. Estamos en la parte en la que las dos piernitas están juntas. And super important, y super importante, we have to put our stitch marker in the beginning of this round. And then we can like close it here because we will need it there for a while. Lo tenemos que, lo cerramos para que se nos quede ahí bien por un ratito. Y de ahí, and then we are gonna continue to round 5 to 6, which means 2 rounds. And then we are gonna stitch around for a total of 32 stitches. En la vuelta número 5 y la vuelta número 6 vamos a hacer una pasada que va a unir las dos piernas y tenemos un total de 32 puntadas. And we will have a total of 32 stitches. This is gonna join the legs. Are you ready? Let's go. ¿Estamos listos? Vamos. Six so far, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And now we are coming close to the part where we join the next leg. And estamos cerca de la parte donde nos unimos con la otra patita. Cogemos la otra patita y hacemos un punto enano o corrido y de ahí un punto bajo arriba. Vamos a ver si sí fue así. Now we have these two joined and we can continue crocheting around. Ya tenemos estas dos unidas y podemos seguir haciendo los puntos bajos alrededor. 30, 31, and 32. So now we move our stitch marker to the last one that we have. We should have a total of 32 stitches. Terminamos la ronda y cambiamos el marcador al lugar donde terminamos. And now, as you can see, I'm gonna pull my crochet hook so you can see better. Voy a quitar el marcador, la aguja para que puedan ver bien. Hemos unido las dos patitas. We have joined both legs together. So now we have very little left, and that's great. According to the pattern, we need to stitch around again, one more time. So let's go. De acuerdo al patrón, tenemos que hacer otra vuelta de la misma manera. Así que vamos. Se me enredó el marcador. I got my marker here attached to the yarn. A lot. Yeah. All right, so now finally Now we go, round number six. But maybe there's some questions in here, so I'm gonna stop for a second and see. Gracias por estos momentos, lo acabo de descubrir, soy discapacitada, uso oxígeno 24 horas al día si no salgo. Para mí esto es una gloria. Leonor, me encanta tu comentario, estoy muy contenta de que pueda ayudar a que utilices el tiempo de una manera productiva. Hay que mantener la energía hacia arriba y muchos, muchos, muchos abrazos para usted. You have 36 stitches, Alejandra. Maybe you can check because I have done this witch several times and it have always counted 32. So I don't know. Does it look very weird? Because if it has 36, maybe it will be a little bit fatter, but I don't think it will like make much of a difference. So maybe you can try with that. Yeah, otherwise you will have to start joining them again, but I don't think so, that I don't think it would make a big difference, so I will encourage you just to continue. Sin está mostrando en vivo cómo hacer una brujita. Okay, there's no question, so I'm gonna continue. We have 32 stitches, tenemos 32 stitches, 32 puntadas. Ronda número 6, round number 6. Pretty soon we are done with round number 6. I have to remember to keep my hands down so you can see well. Alright, I'm quiet because I need to concentrate in the number of these stitches. Estoy calladita porque necesito concentrarme aquí con el número de estas puntadas. And we are done with round number 6. As you see here, we are already giving some shape. The witch, estamos listos con la vuelta número 6. Como ven aquí, ya se le está dando más forma a la al cuerpo y lo comparamos con este otro de aquí, de nuestra brujita, y aquí se ve que vamos bien y tiene el mismo tamaño y todo. It has the same size, we are going well. And yeah, let's make a little bit of a stretch. Remember always to stretch in that way you can keep crocheting for many, many years, otherwise you can have carpal tunnel syndrome and tendinitis, and that sucks. I had it before and I couldn't crochet like in 2 months, and I started having this thing that I call abstinence syndrome due to lack of crocheting. So I was super anxious, I didn't know what to do, I started moving everything at home and it was not a pleasant thing. So now I stretch maybe every 20 to 30 minutes. Yes, I'm gonna translate into Spanish first. Acuérdense de estirar. Es muy importante estirar para evitar síndrome del túnel carpiano y para evitar tendinitis. Yo tuve tendinitis hace unos cuantos años, me tocó dejar de hacer cualquier cosa con las manos por 2 meses y fue horrible. Tenía síndrome de abstinencia, necesitaba mis agujas de crochet y me hizo muchísima falta. Empecé a mover todo en la casa, a echar cantaleta, así que no les recomiendo que se dejen enfermar. Someone is asking me where are we translating from? We are transmitting from Finland. Finland is up in the north, close to Russia. We are very, very far away and it's night already. Pretty soon we are gonna have nights that are very, very long and yeah, we are transmitting from the land of Santa Claus. Estamos transmitiendo desde Finlandia, desde Helsinki. Helsinki, Finlandia es arriba, arriba, arriba en el norte, al lado de Suecia y al lado de Rusia. Es muy lejos, muy, muy lejos. Y es la tierra de Santa Claus y ya casi empieza el invierno y es muy oscuro y por eso se ve como si está de noche, porque está de noche. All right, so we continue. So now we are moving to round number 7. And round number 7 to round number 11, we are gonna just continue stitching around. En la ronda número 7 a la ronda número 11, vamos a continuar haciendo pasadas normales para un total de 32 puntadas. 11, that means 5 rounds. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, yes, 5 rounds. Eso significan 5 vueltas alrededor. So let's go. In this round, since we is gonna take a while, maybe you can tell me what is our second question. Our second question is, what is your scary story? Have you ever had some scary anecdote that you would like to tell us? Nuestra segunda pregunta es, ¿cuál es su historia de terror? ¿Ha habido alguna historia de terror que las ha asustado mucho o alguna experiencia que las haya asustado mucho? So, I reserve this question for the long, long round. It's 5 rounds that we are going to be doing the same. So, let's go. Yes, I'm going to say hi to Santa. He lives in Rovaniemi all year around and now they are preparing for Christmas up there. Okay, vamos. While we crochet these rounds, I'm gonna tell you my scary story. Oh, yeah. When I was younger, I used to live in a haunted house that we inherited from my grandparents. So every time I would go to bed, my father liked to train a lot. He has a small gym at home in the third floor in that house that we used to live. So in the evenings, in the nights, when everybody was going to bed, the ghosts, or I don't know what it was, the spirit or something, were moving the gym, and that was freaking scary. So you will hear this in the night, that is when people is moving metal. And then we will go in the morning and no one was, like, it was in how we left it. That was one of the scary things. And then when we were going away for vacations or something, some neighbors will come to water our plants. We love plants, so we have a lot of plants. And they will not want to stay even watching TV at home because they said that the house was haunted, that you could hear chains and you could hear water running and things like that. So people was really scared of that house. Mi historia de terror. Cuando yo estaba más pequeña, papás heredaron de sus abuelos. Esa casa.
Wait, one second. You're out from the.
Y resulta que en esa casa espantaban. Entonces, a mi papá gustado entrenar muy duro. Él entrena como levantando pesas y entrena artes marciales y todo eso. Entonces, él tenía un gimnasio pequeñito.
Try to get it up there. No, no, just move away to the white area and we can move the camera.
Okay. There. And we move it from here. There. ¿Dónde estaba? Ah, bueno. Entonces mi papá tenía un gimnasio muy pequeño en el último piso. Y por la noche, cuando le echamos llave al tercer piso, resulta que eso empezaba a sonar como si estuvieran corriendo los metales de las pesas. Toda la noche como si estuvieran corriendo las todas esas cosas que se usan para entrenar. Y yo vivía entre los vecinos, cuando nosotros nos íbamos de vacaciones, nosotros les pedíamos el favor, nos regalan las plantas, tenemos muchas plantas y se morían. Entonces, los vecinos casa y decían que no, que ellos no, ni se quedaban viendo televisión porque se escuchaban cadenas, se escuchaban gente gritando, se escuchaban un montón de cosas. Y esa era de terror. We sold that house and I have never come back there again. It was too scary. Vendimos la casa y de ahí nos tan miedoso. Okay, I'm moving my marker. You need to move the brightness a little bit,
Yeah.
please. So yes, please tell me your scary story. Have you ever had any paranormal encounter with the other side? Más acá, cuénteme su vuelta número 9. I am now in round number 9 and I He's gonna fall. Blooper. Mía, can you put back, please? La mía fue ver un duende cuando era chica. ¡Uy, qué susto! ¿Y qué? ¿Cómo se ven los duendes? Cuéntanos, Susie. Susie saw a goblin when she was a child. That must be scary. Let's see. Sus pensé, one night when we were asleep, I must have been around 2 a.m. There was a massive crash in the house, the sound of glass smashing and a thud down the stairs. We went to have a look, wondering what it could be. It was a picture that fallen off the wall and rolled and crashed down the stairs. Not really very scary, but it was at the time. I can't understand because you are not expecting that that thing happened, and then you think like, oh my God, who did this? All the spirits of the evil are in my house. Nadie me creo, pero fue muy real. Yo te creo, Susi. Yo también creo que los duendes existen. No te preocupes. En Colombia hay muchas historias sobre duendes. Susie tells me that not many people have believed in her story, but I tell her that I believe so because in Colombia there's many stories about goblins that fall in love with ladies and then they haunt them and they scratch them and they do all kinds of horrible things to them. Ya hay historias de duendes que se enamoran de muchachas bonitas y las arañan, las molestan, les jalan el cabello. Mejor dicho, muchas cosas. Sí que te creo, Susi, te creo. Alright. So now I'm in round 10. I have one more to go. What is your scary story, Hug Ninjas? Let me know. ¿Cuál es su historia tenebrosa, Hug Ninjas? Déjenme saber.
Move your hands more.
In the meanwhile, I'm gonna tell you another story. There was when I graduated from high school, I studied in a very, very old Catholic school. And in that Catholic school, there was a theater. And in that theater, there was someone told us that some gardener have killed a girl in the theater. And there was like a inner part of the theater that had like a dressing room and showers and everything. And I don't know, I didn't believe that someone died in there, but there was a very weird presence in there always. Every time I will walk in there, I will ask someone to come with me because I was really scared and I could feel like a pressure in my back. Like if someone was looking at you every time you will go to a theater, and I was in the theater group, and one time we were organizing actually a haunted house, and I had a friend that she managed to get a tape that was like I don't know, like a haunted tape or something that a friend gave her for the haunted house. And we started playing that tape and rehearsing for the haunted house, and the lights start flickering, and no one was turning them on and off, and we were all together, and we were laughing like, ha ha ha, we are gonna have so much fun with this. Haunted houses are so silly, ha ha ha. And then the light starts flickering and flickering, and then we hear a sound like a scratching sound like this. It was so scary, and those lights didn't start flickering, so my friend turned off the switch, and the lights kept flickering anyway. That was the most scary thing I have ever experienced in my life. That was good that I was not alone, otherwise, I would have had a heart attack for sure. Okay, en español, una vez, cuando yo estudiaba en un colegio católico muy viejo, había un teatro y ese teatro estaba embrujado, o eso era lo que nos decían pues allá en el colegio, que había una niña ahí adentro. Y resulta que una vez estábamos organizando una casa embrujada y una amiga mía se consiguió una cinta que tenía como unas voces todas diabólicas ahí. Y cuando pusimos la cinta, empiezan las luces a prenderse y apagarse, a prenderse y apagarse. Y nosotros creíamos que era alguien que estaba haciéndonos una broma. Y resulta que estábamos todas juntas y las luces seguían prendiéndose y apagándose. Entonces mi amiga, que es toda incrédula, llegó y apagó el switch. Y las luces siguieron prendiéndose y apagándose. Y nosotros nos morimos de susto. Y yo creí que me iba a dar un infarto. Okay, so I have finished now round number 7 to 11, and you should have a total of 32 stitches. Acabo de terminar en la ronda de la número 7 a la número 11. Y tienen que tener en total 32 puntadas. Si tienen un poquito más de puntadas y ustedes ven que de todas maneras se ve bien, no le paren bolas a eso. Sigan adelante, que de todas maneras su amigurumi se va a ver bien. If, for example, you have one stitch more or two stitches more and you still can see the figure of your amigurumi, please don't unravel. Just continue. It doesn't have to be exact. It's amigurumi, and amigurumi is freedom and feelings, so it doesn't really matter. So, let's continue. Now we are going to round number 12, and in round number 12 we are gonna decrease to create a little bit of like a triangular shape. En la ronda número 11 vamos a hacer una disminución para hacer una forma de un poquito como de triángulo, pero primero vamos a mirar qué dicen nuestros amigos. Let's see what our friends say. Feos, realmente vivamos detrás de una carpintería y se me apareció en la puerta de la casa y desde ese día soy fanática de las duendes. Uy, qué susto. The goblin appear behind in the wooden house. And since then she's a fan of goblins. And then the goblin sounds very scary. Yes, the goblin sounds very scary. Alguien dijo que lo del duende suena muy, muy, muy miedoso. Alright, so now, round number 12. Invisible decrease in next stitch and single crochet in next two stitches around, and we will have a total of 20 stitches. En español, una disminución y dos puntos bajos para un total de 20. Alright? Let's go. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, seven, eight, ten, nine. In this one, I have to stay super quiet because I lose the counting really fast. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 16, 17, and 18. All right, so I have decreased for round number 12, and now I change the marker to the right place. He terminado la ronda número 12 y he puesto mi marcador donde terminamos. Let's see if there's... Quedaron los 18 puntos en la cabeza. Quedarán los mismos puntos para unir. Let me check. Vamos a terminar con 20 puntos en el cuerpo, pero se unen bien de todas maneras, porque solamente hay 2 puntos de diferencia. Aquí se ve. She was asking that she's making the head, so that she said that there's 18 stitches left in the head, and she was asking if in the body is the same amount of stitches left when you finish to join. And I told her that no, that is 18, in the head is 18, but in the body is 20, but that it really doesn't matter because we can join anyway. There's like only 2 stitches of difference, and it looks okay in my eyes. So alright, so for our last join, and then we are finished for today, is one round of stitch around for a total of 20 stitches. En la ronda número 13 y la última para terminar hoy es una pasada, una sola pasada, y para un total de 20. De nada, Leonor. Alright, let's go. Listos, vamos. Ya casicito. Alright, so here we have last round, round number 13. We have a total of 20 stitches. So now we are gonna grab our stuffing. Terminamos la ronda 3. Tenemos un total de 20 puntadas en nuestro proyecto. Y ahora vamos a agarrar nuestra relleno. We are gonna grab a little bit of our stuffing. As I told in the beginning, I am recycling an IKEA cushion. Como les comenté en el principio. There's something playing in there. Check it out, I became a ghost. Hello. You just need to transition. Yeah, yes, I'm back. Woohoo! It was really hard to become a ghost and come back. Oh, okay. So, you are gonna feel, as I was saying, I am recycling IKEA pillow. Why? I will tell you why. Because when I go to the craft stores here in Finland to get half of what I get in this bag of stuffing, I have to pay about 13 euros. But this pillow that I buy, I use, and then I can recycle, costs 3 euros. So, yes, that's why. Les estaba contando. Yo reuso muchas almohadas. ¿Por qué? Porque es saludable botar las almohadas de vez en cuando, para que no se llenen de ácaros, más que todo, yo soy súper alérgica, entonces por eso, y porque en las tiendas de aquí, para comprar materiales de costura y todo eso, me cobran 17 euros por un paquetito así, entonces yo lo que hago es que compro una almohada, y me vale 3 euros, y listo. Alright, so now we are gonna fill in our body. You just add enough stuffing. Sí, Leonor, ahorita la miro, ahorita miro tu cabeza. I'm gonna fill, I'll put a little bit more. Voy a poner un poquito más. And then I'm gonna try to put it all the way. Maybe I put too much, let's take out. And then we have our body. And it looks like this. So now what we are gonna do is, ya tenemos nuestro cuerpo, lo moldeamos bien. Dejar una colita grande para coserlo a la cabeza la próxima semana. We leave a long tail for sewing next week. And then we remove our marker. Quitamos el marcador para ver qué tal nos fue. Y aquí tenemos el cuerpo. Este mismo cuerpo lo pueden usar para hacer corazones, por ejemplo. The same way you can make hearts, for instance. So, let's make a last round of questions to see if our friends have any questions. Miremos a ver si nuestros amigos tienen alguna pregunta. Qué bien, muy inteligente y económica. Muchas gracias. Hago lo que puedo. Muy buena forma de economizar. Aquí valen más las almohadas que ir a comprar al vellón por kilo. Qué bien por ustedes. Aprovechen bastante porque aquí, donde yo vivo, los implementos para manualidades son súper caros. Cuando yo voy a Colombia me surto de todo. Alright, so if you don't have any questions, amigas, ¿tienen alguna pregunta o comentario? If you have any questions, it's the time to do them before we finish our crochet along for today. So let's see if you have any questions, more questions. Yeah, there's a question. And I became a ghost again. Hello. Faltarán los pelos y el gorro. Sí, terminaré los pelos y el gorro, los haremos la próxima semana. Y todavía soy un fantasma. Estamos experimentando cómo hacer los live stream un poquito más más dinámicos. Por eso es que me estoy convirtiendo en un fantasma cada rato. Okay, but I want to thank you everybody for tuning into this podcast or podcast, no, live stream. I want to also thank Sharon for sharing the live stream with her huge community. I want to thank everybody that us and that is doing this crochet along with us. Please put pictures of your project, your work in progress. I would love to see what you are doing, and I would love to share with you other hook ninjas in Spanish now. Quiero agradecerles muchísimo, muchísimo por unirse a esta iniciativa. Espero que les haya gustado, que todo esté bien explicado. Si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, no duden en escribirme. Y tómenle fotos a sus proyectos y me los muestran, que a mí me encanta ver lo que ustedes hacen. Muéstrenme sus brujitas. I hope to see you next week and see you guys. Let's see. Te agradezco mucho. Fue con mucho, mucho gusto. See you, Sue. See you, Leonor. Chao, Leonor. Chao, Susie. And I hope to see you next time. Bye. And now our screen got shut down, and I don't know if what happened. Let's see. But I can't. Yes, here we are back. Hello. Yeah, I want to see you. Bye. And chao, chicas. Muchas gracias por todo. Bye, bye. Bye, bye. Mwah. Transition.